Greetings once again, everyone. Since this is pretty much the halfway point on the people that I felt have been the most impactful to me in pop culture and what have you, I thought I'd take a moment to talk about fellow YouTubist, the Mount Vernon Kid. Now, I found out about Chris's channel through someone else's channel, which I'll go more into when I get to that individual who'll be coming up in a day or two. But anyway, when I came across MVK's channel, I wasn't listening to his take on comics or his take on manga or his take on gaming or wrestling or what have you. The first video that I came across that was Chris's was when he was talking about someone, I believe her name was BK Angel. And apparently she was going through a bit of a rough patch relationship wise because just listening to it from Chris's perspective, because I never really checked out her videos too much, apparently she was at the time in a relationship with someone who was of a different ethnic origin than herself. And Chris, being able to relate to that situation, was sort of consoling her and what's the term? Relating to her his situation of a, you know, of a similar nature. And the thing you could tell was that he was being 100% genuine, 100% sincere, and talking about the hurdles and struggles that he was going through being in the relationship that he was in with someone that he cared about, cares about very much, you know. So I'm listening to this and I'm like, you know, really blown away by how compelling it is of what he's talking about, you know. And at that point when I was done listening to him, I did not immediately check out other videos of his, because, you know, that was really just some deep stuff that he was getting into. But about a week later or so, I came back to his channel and he was doing the stuff that he does, you know, on the regular, that all of you know about, you know. And and the thing was, whether it was an opinion spot about comics or about movies or sports or sports entertainment or something, you could definitely pick up on how genuine he was on every topic. The man, the man's mind is like a human the man's mind is like a human Rolodex, you know, or like a mental Rolodex. And the stuff that he can pull forth information wise though I'm, shall we say, several years his senior, information wise he knows tons more, he'll forget tons more than I'll ever know, more than likely, on most of the stuff that he addresses in pop culture. And with Chris having such a big heart. I think the what I'll wrap this up with is simply to say that when you sort of enter, as he sometimes puts it, his world, you are actually entering what I consider to be more so probably than anybody else that I've come into contact with on the internet and YouTube in particular. You've entered into a community, and Chris puts himself out there to where he's not too proud as to not accept help from someone if he needs it, and he's not too his nose is not up in the air when it comes to helping someone out if they need help. And I think that's something that is commendable, and there should be more people like that. And finally, to sum it up, I think this quote probably says it best. Unfortunately, it comes from a wrestler that I can't stand, namely Hulk Hogan, but a good quote is a good quote regardless of the source. And that quote is, don't mistake kindness for weakness. Because I know there's people out there, there's lurkers out there, that they see you have a kind heart, they want to take advantage of it and whatnot. And I can tell you, from what I've listened to, Chris ain't that person that you want to try that kind of stuff on. And although he's kind-hearted, he's not a fool. And there's a reason why he's nicknamed, or he's nicknamed himself from time to time, Hurricane Chris. Because if something is awry, he doesn't have a problem expressing himself in a very, to use another wrestling term, hardcore sort of way. Anyway, that puts the Mount Vernon Kid in my at my number 6 spot. Big props to the Mount Vernon Kid. And when I next return, I'll come back with the second half of this deal, which will be continuing on with the YouTube Crusaders and why I like them for the reason I like them. Until next time, night out.